nature of a drive, you know, like Abraham Maslow talked about the basic human drives, you know, for hunger, thirst, sexuality, and so on and so forth. And in one sense, that's part of how the ego is a drive. It's driving. It strives. It's not still. The ego is never still. It never arrives. It's always perpetually striving. And that's why the busyness can come in with that too. And I found that over the years, as I just gave way to purpose, and I really let myself be taken into purpose, I could see that pleasure and pain both reinforce the reality of the body. If you have a splitting headache or you have an ecstatic orgasm, you're very aware of the body. And I could see the course lessons were saying, I'm not a body, I'm free, I'm still as God created me, I am spirit, you know, I am the Holy Son of God Himself. It's an interesting workbook lesson when you start to take it on. But divinity is transcendent of all duality, so there's no pleasure or pain in divinity. There's joy, and there's an experience that comes from being in total alignment with Source. But you have to be taken step by step up into that alignment. The Spirit never is judging anything in form as good or bad. It's just egoic judgments that would try to judge for or against something. And you could say there's pushes, there's pulls, there's attractions, there's repulsions. But the more you give yourself over to being in alignment with Spirit, you actually come more into the state like in deep meditation where you just have this vast experience, but it's not like a feeling of being in the world or in the body or grounded in any way. It's actually, it's transpersonal, it's transcendent. And that becomes more and more the predominant experience. And then what I have found in my own life as I've gone into that, then it's like what seem to be appetites or drives start to fade. And fade and fade and fade and fade. And you feel less and less human. Because the drives are so associated with the human identity, you feel actually less and less human. And more vast, like you're not located. Like you're not really located in time and space. It's very, very transcendent. But again, you just work with it one step at a time. The Spirit isn't judging things as positive or negative. It's just, I think, the more you're called into your function and fulfilling your function, then that's where you come into greater alignment, and that's the whole purpose.